Hey guys, welcome to Cybernetico. I am back with another video. As other people say in their videos, I am just copying this line. So in this video, we will see one important thing. So we have come across some cases where you see we have embedded data in database. And the reason for this is if we fill some form without entering the data will be saved in this API. And in the database. So that's not a good practice. So to prevent it, we can add form validation in React. So click submit without entering the data. We'll get the errors called, please check the first name, please check the last name and email and password. So that is one thing. We have done that. And the second thing is, let's say we entered some text which is not valid. So your name or my name only contains text, alphabetical text, not numbers. It's not like I am Nishant 2.0 or something. So if we enter some name here called Nishant, it's valid because it is not a number, it is a character. It is an alphabet. If we enter some number here, let's say 1, 2, 3, you see it is not valid because we are not allowing numbers here. And we will see how to use this property here. Let me explain here it. So we are using this pattern called regex pattern. So this checks only the alphabetical characters. This allows only alphabetical characters. The second thing is max length here, which is 10 characters. So if we enter some name which is more than 10 characters, we will get the error called please check the first name. We can also use all the three elements which is required to max length 10 and pattern this text element here, only text characters or alphabetical characters. So let's type some useless name. So let's say NIS, some number which is more than 10. So you are getting this error called please check the first name. And we're repeating this all the things for all other input elements, for last name, email, password. In short, I am just running validation. And now, in this video, we will see how to do that. So let's get started. So as you can see, I have a form here which contains first name, last name, email and password. So right now, the form is empty. I mean, we don't have any properties or any functions to get data from the form. We also have a submit button at that bottom. So we can color it. So give color as, let's say, black. Then now let's install this package called React Hook Form. It will be used for validation. So just use command called npm install React Hook Form or yarn add React Hook Form. Wait for it to install. You can read the documentation of this React Hook Form if you want to get it more cleared in your skull or head. So we have this code here. First we need to import it at the top. So let's import it. React import use form from React hook form. Then we need to destructure this use form inside our function form validation. Remember that this React hook form only works with functional component in React, not class components. And I advise you all to use functional component while creating React temps because it's feasible and easy. Then we need to declare one on submit method which contains handle submit property here from here. Then we need to create this on submit function first. So const on submit, I think it's right. Okay, make it an arrow function. It will take a parameter called data, and we can check in the console. So console.log data. Then we need to declare the form field name properties. For example, they should be first name, they should be last name, they should be email, and the last one should be password. So let's do that. We need to use this property called register, and inside the register we have a property, another property or attribute called example. So if we put this here, it means the first name has property of example. Let me show you by doing practical. So open the console here, clear it and type some first name here called Nishant. Click submit and you see the property name we had is example. Let me zoom it in. So we see you have example property here. So we don't need example, we need here first name. So first name. And now if we clear the console, refresh the page and check again, we will get Nishant here as first name. So you see we are getting first name as Nishant in an object. We can repeat it for all other properties, for last name, email and password. So this would be last name, this should be email, and the last one should be password. So now refresh the page and check again, enter all the details, anything you want, and click submit. So we are getting all the four datas here: email, first name, last name and password. Now we need to add validations here. So let's say if we enter some name which is wrong, or let's say we enter some number in the input box, then in that case we should see the errors that we should get. So let me give you a practical here. So first let me give you the practical of example of required. So let's make the all four fields as required. So just add required as true here after first name. Now let's check, click submit, we are getting nothing. So we can declare the mode here as mode should be on change. Now we also need to add the error here. So you can see we are getting this error as error example require and the message. So after form fields, this should be first name, the name of property, and the field is required. Now let's check, click submit. Okay, we are getting nothing. So I think we need to use the message here as required. Now let's check, click submit. We're still getting nothing. Okay, wait a sec. So we have another watch. We don't need this watch, so remove it. We have first name required. Okay. Oh, okay, it is working now. So if we click submit here, we will see this message called this field is required, which is coming from here. So let's make it a P tag. So make it a P. Now it's much better. So we can use some custom message like please enter the first name. So we will get this error here called please enter the first name. We can repeat it for all other elements, all other properties. So make the required true in the second input, which is last name. So required is true here, and the error message after form field. So make it last name, submit or refresh the page, click submit. See, we see we're getting please enter the first name and it should be last name here, last name. So we have the error here. We can repeat it for other also. So just copy required is true. Note this, because this is only for required. We will see some custom messages or validation. So for example, let's say we type some number inside the name field, and you know it's not valid because we don't have numbers in names. So in that case we will use some regex validation. I will show you it later. So first it should be here. So this should be password, and this one should be email. make it email. This should be password. Save. Refresh the page and click submit. So you see we are getting all the four messages here. Enter the first name, last name, email and password. We can also make it a bold text. So give this P a class name of text error. Error. Repeat it in all other errors, in all other P tags. And then we will use the class name here. So text error. This should be font weight as 600. So you see it's now bold, color as red. Now it's it's looking much better. Now the thing is, we need to add regex validation here. So let's check here. So you see we have the pattern property here also after required. So first let me show you the max length property in the first name. So copy max length and paste it after required. So it means the maximum length should be 20 of the first name. So if we type 5 here and check, refresh it and type some name with the length of maximum length of, sorry, type some name with length more than 5. So we will see we get this error called please enter the first name. So we can also add some custom message, but how do we do that? Okay, let's check. Okay, we don't need, okay, first name, please enter the first name. We cannot do that, I think. So we can just use please check the first name. And if we type name in the range of 5 characters, this will disappear. So click submit. Okay, max length is 5. Refresh the page. Okay, wait a sec. Let me check here. So max length is 20 here. Okay, let's try to backspace it, minimum the characters. So you see it is now 4. If we type 5th character, it's valid. We are not getting any errors. And if we type 6th character, you will see we're getting this error called please check the first name. Let's make it as 10 and save. Refresh the page, type some name like N-I-S-H-A-N-T. So Nishant is valid because it has 7 characters. And let's type some more characters like A, B, C. So now it has 7 plus 1 space and this A, B, C. So 11 characters it is. So it is now 10, let's try 11. So it has 11 characters, which is more than 10. And so we are getting the error called please check the first name. Now let's try to add the pattern here. So you see the pattern here is for all the numeric characters. So after this max length, just add pattern. And now let's check, refresh. Let's type some number here. So you see we're getting this error called please check the first name because the pattern here is for only alphabet characters. If we type some characters which is alphabet, this will disappear. If we remove this and type some number again, you see we will not get any error. Okay, it was more than 10. So now you know how to use these three elements as combinations. So if it is empty, click submit, we will get the error called please check the first name. If we type some name more than 10 characters, we will get an error. So you see we have 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, whatever. Okay, we have more than 10, so we are getting this error called please check the first name. Then if you type some invalid character like number or symbols, we will get the error please check the first name. but it is valid for numeric, sorry, it is valid for text characters. So let's repeat it for the second property, which is last name. Put it here. So max length true required, max length 10 required true, and pattern here. So the third element is email. So we have required, we need to remove it and give it a space or a enter. Then required true. Okay, these two elements also need to be removed, and paste it here. Now let's check the regex for email. So just type regex for email validation. You can see this in tutorials point. So this email is valid. Where is the regex here? So this is the regex. So copy the all the characters inside text and remove this, and let's replace the pattern here. Okay, wait. I think we need to use for JavaScript. So we have Stack Overflow here. This is the pattern, I think. Or okay, we have this varied address. Okay, copy this pattern and replace the text pattern here. So if we enter the email here, we will still get an error, I think. So max length, remove it, because email should be of any characters. So let's enter my email. So we are getting this valid message. We are getting no errors because the email is valid. If we remove it, okay, and click submit, nothing will happen because I think this is invalid regex. We need to find some valid regex here, and you know that is difficult. So we can just go down here and check the regex in the form. So I think if we check this code examples here, we will see the regex for email. So only we need basic validation. Open up here. We don't need this upgrade. So okay, wait, late is loading. So wait for it to load. How to decrease the size here? Click sandbox. Okay, first name, last name. So email. Okay, pattern here is it? This is the pattern here. So copy the pattern. Okay, it's too much long, and place the pattern here. Oh my god, it's too large. The pattern is too big. But if it works, so what should be the problem? Save it, and now let's check. Refresh the page. Enter some email, it is working. So we have to make the error as please check the email. So this email is wrong because we are not using .com. If we type here .com, you see it is not in, still not valid. Okay, what is the problem? Errors not email pattern. Okay, you don't need this. So what is the problem here? Refresh it. Okay, it's fine. So if we enter some valid email, it works fine. And if we enter some wrong email, you see it is giving some errors. So you see we are getting this error called please check the email. If we enter the right email, like nishan444040@gmail.com, it will disappear. And now let's do for the last one, which is password. So I think where is the password? It's mobile number. Developer. We have mobile number. Okay. Go back and let's check for password. Custom validation, basic validation, basic, basic, basic. You need to research this, all other or the validations here. So we can just see the custom validations here that we get here. Email, we have age, we don't have password here. So we can just see the right validation for password. So just type regex for password in JavaScript. So here is the regex. Let's check if this works or not. Okay, let's use this one because it has minimum eight characters and maximum 20 characters. You see here at the last 8 to 20, then we need maximum one uppercase element here, one lowercase element here, and one digit which is here. Then we need one special character also. So let's try this one. So just use here pattern and copy the regex here. So let's make it as 6 to 10. Now let's check. So refresh it and let's try to enter this password. So let's make it, please enter the, okay, please check the password. If we enter in the range, so okay, wait, sorry, not here, it is not working. Please check the password. So this validation is wrong. Fine, no problem. Let's try this small one, this pattern here, replace it as this. So this is, it means it should contain one number. It should contain one number and one special character. Let's try this one. Still nothing. Okay. It's hard to find regex like this. So this is the resource W3 element. W3 resources, sorry. So this is a password which is, so copy this pattern and place it here. So it should contain one capital letter, one small letter, and it should be between 7 to 14. So let's make it 6 to 12. Refresh it. So let's type some, let's try some gibberish. So we will see this error called please check the password. And if we type, let's say N capital IS ABC 1 2 3, so we will see the error has been disappeared because we have number here and we have the one capital letter and one small letter, and it's between 6 to 12 characters. And if we increase more than 12 characters, we see getting this error called please check the password. And if it is in range of 6 to 12, this message will disappear. Now let's see all other, let's check all the validations here. So Nishant, wait a sec, Nishant, okay, Nishant here, one capital letter, one small letter. And if we want a numeric digit, we can use this one. So copy it and place it here. You can use this resource called JavaScript resource from W3Schools, which contains this data. So it should be 6 to 20. Let's make it 15. So it should contain a number. Oh, wait a second. What the? So it should contain. Where is it? Okay, 5 mm. 6 to 15 characters and one uppercase, one lowercase, and one digit. So let's check. Type some gibberish. Okay, there is a problem. It is not working. Okay. Input type is text here. Click submit. Okay, now it's fine. I think it's some network issue in my device. So if we now, okay, wait. So you see we are getting error because we are entering some wrong password which does not match validation. So let's try some right password. One capital letter, one small letter, and one number. So you see it is now between 6 to 15 characters and it has one capital letter, one small letter, and one number. Now our validation in the fourth, all the four fields is working very good. And if we type some name, a password here, some valid email and sorry, some valid data and click submit here, it will show up in the console. So click submit. We are getting all the data, email, first name, last name, and password. And if we try some wrong data, which is not match validation, we will not get here because the validation is active here. We will only get the data when our all the four fields is active and which matches the pattern which we put here. And now you know how to add validation in React forms in functional component using React hook form. So please subscribe to the channel and I will leave a link to the resource in the description. So as usual, don't forget to subscribe my channel and leave a like here. Thank you so much for watching my video. Happy learning.